Welcome back, Sins and Commandments alike. This is Griever, your guys' host as always, bringing you guys the latest episode review of Wrath of the Gods. Now that is about as excited and as much passion I'm going to be able to put into this review because, guys, this episode was shit. Like, there's just no other way to see it. There isn't. I don't know how they're taking some of prime Taizai and doing this to it. Like, if you couldn't produce 24 episodes in quality, give me 16. Yeah, like, no, I'm serious. You know the reason, the reason this has come about is because, yeah, I got, what do they call them, a guilty pleasure or something like that. I got a guilty pleasure. I enjoy the first couple of seasons of Sword Art Online. Like, once it gets into the Alfheim part and stuff. But the first, like, 13 episodes, when they were actually in Aincrad and stuff, I enjoy that. I was rewatching that, the last couple days. And honestly, for every single shot they have where a character's face looks a little, like, chubby or a little off or, like, okay, that, like, there's no detail in the faraway shot or something, for every one of those, they have a crazy flowing hair, crazy, detail animation on the armor, just all this stuff. And I'm just like, so you can forgive. Honestly, it was hard to find. And the reason this came about is because I'm going to be reviewing the entirety of the series because I just binge-watched. In one day, I binge-watched, Magmal? It's that new Netflix anime show about a new continent, Magmal showing up and stuff. Anyway, I binged the whole thing, and there was some stellar animation there and stuff. And I'm sitting back, and I think it's because after watching a show like that and rewatching Sword Art Online and seeing what good quality animation can be. Coming back, I rewatched episode 2, and now I just watched episode 3, and no, guys, there's no excuse. I tried to make excuses, in the first couple episode reviews. I did. I tried to say, well, the first one was kind of filler, so it didn't really count. Second one, there was some good and some bad, but this one, like, I don't care how many good shots. The problem is, there are only a few, there are good shots, but they're stills. And the really sad part is that even a lot of the stills are bad. Like, they use stills with just mouth flaps, and it's bad. Like, there is very little actual animation in this episode. Like, true, honest, like, real animation, outside of, like, some CGI stuff, some panning. Like, you don't count panning. Remember, zooming in and zooming out and panning left to right. That's not animation. Outside of the CGI stuff, some mouth flaps and stuff like that, everything just looked. And no details on super important moments. In this episode, basically, all right, let's just go down it. But I'm pissed off. This was a horrendous episode, a horrendous adaptation of what this meant, because we had some stellar moments. We had the introduction of the first Archangel, Ludachel, and his introduction shot was bad quality. It was mediocre when it should have been detailed to the nines. Then he didn't even, like, do this whole epic speech. Like, I felt bored. All these bad faraway shots and this one little forest with all these stills and him talking about genocide. Like, it didn't roll off the tongue well. Nothing. Nerobasta's extra lines in this episode also make no sense, I found. Like, Calmadios had no detail on him. He was just a big hulking, like, copy-paste droll's head on him and it looked the same. Like, there didn't seem to be anything forethought into this episode. Like, Ludachel's super detailed, like, alright, I'm gonna commit mass genocide on all the demons, was good, but not great. They could have done so much more with it. Remember, they're super detailed in the manga, right? There's super detailed shots in the manga, but there's still stills. You need to improve on that. The whole point of an anime is they are limited by not having moving pictures. Doesn't mean that every single epic shot in the manga needs to be a still of lesser quality. That's my problem. That's my problem, is that the manga panels of stills are better than the anime stills, and the stills in the anime are the only highlights. That's horrendous. That means if I did a picture slideshow with audio of these manga chapters in color, it would be better than the whole of the episode. And that is a fact, ladies and gentlemen. It is a fact. There was more detail in a faraway panel shot in the manga on one of Elizabeth Nerobaster Ludeshiel's wings than throughout this entire episode. Everybody's faces looked fat and off and not angled. It looked like a kid drew. There was one shot where Elizabeth was healing a dude's arm, and that looked like it was drawn by a five-year-old. Who did the shading on Ludeshiel's boots? Because there's a still image. Fraudrin has never looked like so much of a kid's drawing of a grimace. His eyes aren't even proportioned right. The mouth on his chest doesn't even look right. Like, they literally didn't even do the proper character designs. Monspeet didn't really even look like Monspeet. Derriere had some detail, but Elizabeth had zero detail. There's another one. Okay, so basically, they fight Calmadios, whatever, and he goes away and stuff. And that should have been way more epic. It wasn't, because Calmadios never had any real, like where was the detailed shots of Calmadios raging or something? This is where you add a little filler, ladies and gentlemen. I don't care about some extra dialogues between Deanne and King. Like, screw off with that. Give me some detailed roars from Calmadios. Give me a little bit of extra axe swinging and some coolness, right? You know, they start off a little strong. I was okay with some shots. And don't get me wrong. The one I found was okay for the most part was there were some Ludeshiel shots that seemed good. But once again, they were only stills and they could have been better. The only other one was Glock, Sinya, and Droll. Their stills seemed to be okay. But everybody else looked chunky or not drawn correctly. Or, like, even Meliodas' hair has been looking off, like they're doing too many flips or something every single episode. It's just wrong. There's something really wrong here, guys. I don't like anything that's going on. So, I'm going to keep ranting about this. But pretty much after this, so they fight Calmadios, right? They win, whatever, blah, blah, blah. They rescue some humans. They rescue a human that everybody is mistaken for Bon. Who doesn't look like Bon? This guy does not look like Bon in the anime. Similar, but no. It's copy-paste in the manga. It's the same face. Different hairstyle. It's Bon's face. This guy doesn't even have the same eye angle as Bon. It's not the right shape of eye, let alone anything else. Also, he's way bulkier for some reason. Like, he doesn't appear to be that bulky in the manga. Once again, I reread the manga chapters before I did this, so I know what I'm talking about. Even if you had made him bulkier, why is it not Bon's face? It doesn't look like Bon. Looks like a different character. The eyes are a different width apart, not the whole bit. Like, Ro does not look like Bon. Just saying. And that's stupid. They ruined any chance they had. You could have made so many moments epic. They wasted... Okay, the autofocus isn't working very well. There we go. They wasted moments with the soundtrack. They could have had much more better OSTs playing from the Seven Deadly Sins soundtrack, which they lost chances to use. Especially one where after they rescue these humans, they go to Stigma, they see Ludeshiel. Sorry, sometimes I might call him Rudesiel because that was the original translation or something. And it was a long time before we got the official name. But suffice it to say is that he goes on his whole, oh, here's an archangel, here's genocide, we're going to do this, blah, blah, blah. And that's not nearly as impressive or epic as it should have been. And then after this, we get them sitting around the fire talking about another thing that's a manga-only problem, but the six black knights of the Demon Clan. Who are they? Where are they? Who are they? Nobody knows. Nobody cares anymore, once again. Just like Arthur, Nanashi, all this other stuff. Like, where are these people? Whatever. So that's a bit of a spoiler there, guys, for these six Black Knights you heard of, Demon Knights. You'll never know who they are or see them, because they don't appear in the anime. They don't appear in the manga. So, who are they? After this, we also get... So, during the scene, Ro comes up to Meliodas, and they basically talk, and Ro finds out, like, okay, you're... Like, I figured it out, you're a demon. All this fun jazz, right? And they have this conversation, which should have been... Now, once again, this is your opportunity to extend a few just small lines. Have some pauses. You don't need to regurgitate the manga dialogue as fast as somebody can read a book. Right? Take your time. I don't know about you guys, but I read. I read a lot of books. And when something epic is happening or I'm really into something, sometimes I reread the scene. Or I start reading slower just because I can read, let's say, a page every minute, right? Let's just say I can read a page a minute of a standard size novel. If I'm fully enjoying it and I'm like, oh, wow, this is like the big climax battle, or this is a super romantic moment between two characters I've been following for a whole book series or something, I'm reading every word much slower. It's called pacing. You don't need to, just because it's only 2 pages in the manga doesn't mean it should only be 2 minutes in the anime. Like, that's not how you translate it properly. The pacing's off. They don't even use proper shots to exemplify this. It's all a faraway shot of their backs that are poorly animated in a still with a CGI fire going on in the background. And then one little animated fist bump. Like, oh my, man, this is annoying. And then... After this, we get another epic moment that should have been brilliant. Between some other stuff, like, okay, we find out Jahard is Gloxinia's sister and all that stuff. And King figures it out. He's like, oh shit, so what happened here? You know, all that stuff. Droll, or Deanne in Droll's body, is training some recruits, some Giant Clan people, some members of the Giant Clan. That's all cool. But after this, they figure out that there's... the Ten Commandments are on their way. We have Frodron, we have Gallen, we have Melzukla, Monspy, and we have Derriere, right? Characters we've already been introduced to, but here's them back 3,000 years ago. And they show up, basically, to invade the Fairy King's Forest and all this stuff, and Stigma Headquarters, and it's very like, okay. Once again, very boring animation throughout this whole thing, and then they could have done so much with this scene. Elizabeth, her hair could have been flying. She could have been, you know, like in her face as she slowly tells them, like, I don't even believe it. And then have Derriere try to interrupt. However, you know, do that kind of thing. He's like, I will take your word that there is something wrong here. And I will find out. I will be your mediator. I will be your negotiator. I will do with all within my power to return your friends to you. You need to help work with me with this. I don't want to take innocent lives, you know, like... Expand, like, Jesus, you know, I'm a fan of books, I'm a fan of movies, but you know what the beautiful thing about books and movies, you know what the great thing about comics and movies is, that when something's adapted, they change things, not always for the better, sometimes for the worse, but in general, it's something called poetic license. Just because Nakaba wrote it doesn't mean you have to regurgitate the exact thing shot for shot. They clearly didn't. They didn't do shot for shot. I can prove it. I read the manga. It's different and it's worse. So they didn't even regurgitate it, but they didn't take this opportunity to make an epic confrontation between Elizabeth, who shows up, Meliodas and Deanne and King, they're ready to go. They're going to head there and they're going to try to stop this from happening. But Elizabeth shows up first. After a conversation between Ludichelle and Nero Basta, and Elizabeth flies up. See, I'm skipping stuff, guys, because I just don't care. The whole episode started to piss me off about 5 minutes in, and so I really don't care. You guys should just read the manga. Don't watch this episode. Read the manga. You'll probably enjoy it far better, because this is just so annoying. After seeing what good animation is like over this week, and then coming back to this, for a series that is supposed to be popular, for a series that is supposed to have good animation. How is it that a 24 episode of a no-name, nobody knows it Netflix adaptation, right? Like that Magmel series I just told you about, can have pristine, far better animation throughout the entire 24 episodes than season 3 of Seven Deadly Sins. There's no excuse. That's what I'm saying. There's no excuse for this. It's just, it's abysmal. Because they could have done so much more with this. This scene was like the nail, the final nail in the coffin where I went, this is shit. It's not good. It's not good animation. It's not a good adaptation. And putting in a good OST during the speech from season one, all that is basically, I remember what season one was like. It was actually good. This is not good. It's so bad. There was very few, it was mostly stills with lip flaps. No wings fluttering, no demon aura going on. Everyone looking weird in the background and disproportioned. Elizabeth's hair not moving at all, even though she's hundreds of feet in the goddamn air. Like, oh, this had such an opportunity to do so much more. And even when they do animate it, it's so mediocre or so bad that nobody cares. And then they don't even use the Death Ball Deluxe friggin', well, that's Bleach, but basically the giant arc Death Ball of goddess power, which is what the whole thing was about. They don't even animate that well. You literally only need to do 30 seconds of very good, high quality sister derriere dying, like seeing her like claw or something, like a close up, and see like the light in her eyes fade, some wide eyed Full Metal Alchemist pupil shit going on. We don't get none of that. It's CGI dissolve. Sword Art Online, them dying in CGI pixels looked better in every single episode of Sword Art Online than this entire shot. It was an insult. It's disrespectful. You know why? I think I'm more pissed off because right now, for those of you who don't know, I won't spoil it, but the manga is not doing well. I don't know how it's doing for sales and popularity, but the fans are not happy. I haven't really met a fan that's happy with the current state of it. It's been in a bad place for over a year. It's been in a very bad arc, and Nakaba doesn't seem to know what he's doing. However, a highlight of being a fan is that you can step back, look at the series as a whole, and go, I still love this series. This is a black spot in the series. This is, you know, if you read a series that is 10 books, and you hate book 3, well then don't read book 3. You know what happens if you don't enjoy it. Read book 4 and keep going, right? Read it so you know it. If you didn't enjoy it, whatever, move on. As long as it doesn't ruin the rest of the story, you're okay. But right now, we're in that black spot, unfortunately. So I don't know what's going to happen next. But what I do know is that this was a good part of the series. This Wrath of the Gods season should be some of the best. It should be better than season 2. By default, it should be better than season 2. Season 1 can be argued to be the best part of Taizai, but this is a close second for most of the fans. This was some of the best stuff. And they are treating it so disrespectfully. Anyways, Archangels show up. Who gives a shit? Because we don't even get to see them. Light bulbs, CGI, friggin' glow effect on Sony Vegas used for two of the Archangels showing up. And once again, a bunch of stills of them going, Archangels, mouth flap. Like, whatever. I just don't care. I hope episode 4 is good. I'm going to continue to review the series, but this might turn into a bit of a hate rant series at this point. And I'm sorry for that, ladies and gentlemen. I don't want this review to go on too much longer because it's just going to give me anxiety, honestly. Because this was going to be the thing that we all looked forward to as Taizai fans. As people who read the manga and are upset with the current state of the manga, like myself, this was supposed to be a bit of the light in the darkness. Like, read a crappy chapter of Taizai this week. But tonight, I get to watch the good episode of Taizai this week. It was supposed to be a bit of a balance. But now it's just putting salt on a wound, man. And, yeah. Alright, I'm done. Like, comment, friggin' autofocus, man. It's been so bad lately. like, comment, subscribe, or even dislike if you don't, if you think I'm totally full of shit. But you show me some shots that look good. You show me some stellar animation. You show me anything that looks as good as season one animation. Show me one GIF of animation that looks as good as season one. And, like, I'll wait. Like, I'm serious, because I'm just... Like, comment, subscribe, whatever. Bell notification if you want to know when I drop another video. Most of my videos are not like this. If you're new to the channel, just want to let you know if you stuck around. I'm usually very passionate. I usually try to be not unbiased. Of course, that's the point of my videos, to give you an opinion, my opinion specifically. But I try not to hate on things. I try to see the best side of things, you know. But this, there's no excuse for this. This has been 3 episodes in, and it's not getting better. It's getting worse. And it's an insult to what was otherwise a really good part of the series. So, that being said, ladies and gentlemen, this has been Griever, episode 3 of a now Wrath of the... I don't even have anything for that. I'm not quick-witted like that. So, Wrath of the Shit. Just Wrath of the Shit. Or Wrath of me right now. This is Wrath of Griever. This is the Wrath of the Griever episode 3 review. Drink responsibly. I'm not going to. See ya.